Know your risk. That's the message researchers at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute's Lynch Syndrome Center want people to understand about this relatively common but underdiagnosed genetic condition.
We think that about 1 in 300 people in the U.S. have Lynch syndrome. And so what that means is that about 1 in 300 people out there have an inherited genetic phenomenon that is putting them at risk for a variety of cancers.
Those cancers include, but are not limited to, colon, rectal, uterine, ovarian, and cancers of the urinary tract. Not everyone with Lynch syndrome will develop cancer, but the risk is greater.
The lifetime risk of cancer can run from as low as 20%, depending on the genes that we're looking at and depending on other specific risk factors, to maybe higher than 80%, depending on other factors.
Dr. Matthew Yergelin is the director of Dana-Farber's Lynch Syndrome Center, which was the first center of its kind to open in the country. He says genetic testing can help identify Lynch syndrome carriers, and if you know you're a carrier, then there are several cancer surveillance and prevention measures that can be initiated. And if you develop cancer, there are certain treatments that could be more effective. Dr. Yergelin says it's important for people to be aware of their family's health history to decide if getting tested for Lynch syndrome is needed.
So factors that can be a tip-off that somebody might be at risk for Lynch syndrome would certainly be any family history of Lynch syndrome-related cancers, especially if there's multiple cancers or especially if those cancers were diagnosed at young ages.
The center is working to improve prevention, early detection, and treatment of Lynch syndrome-associated cancers, and that's why they've started the Lynch Syndrome Center Registry. It's a way for patients to share clinical information and biological samples with researchers studying the condition.
We're trying to take advantage of the fact that so many of the individuals and families that we follow with Lynch syndrome really want to be part of the progress, so that we can start to really move the needle forward as far as our understanding of why Lynch syndrome manifests this way in this person and that way in that person, which gets us that much closer to kind of personalized cancer prevention, personalized cancer interception.